Hello friends, today we are going to discuss question on epilepsy. So our question number one is, 22 year old Suma with history of epilepsy is undergoing the pre-anesthetic review. The use of which inhalation agent is contraindicated in this patient? So options are halothane, enflurane, sevoflurane, isoflurane. So the correct answer is here, enflurane. So our option number B is correct here. Now let's move to our next question. So this is the question. A patient presented with short lasting episodic behavioral changes, which include agitation and dreamlike state with thrashing movements of his limbs. He does not recall these episodes and has no apparent precipitating factor. Which of the following is most likely diagnosis? Options are panic episode, schizophrenia, temporal lobe epilepsy, dissociative disorder. The correct answer is here, temporal lobe epilepsy. Okay. So next question is, this is the question. Gustatory hallucinations are most commonly associated with temporal lobe epilepsy, grand mal epilepsy, anxiety disorder, tobacco dependence. The correct answer is here, option number A, that is temporal lobe epilepsy. Okay. So the next question is this. A 27 year old man with epilepsy presents with complaints of persistent lethargy and occasional feeling of intoxication, although he does not consume alcohol. The patient is currently taking phenobarbital for the long-term management of tonic-clonic seizures. In addition, he was recently started a medication for the treatment of gastroesophageal reflux disease. Which of the following agent was he most likely prescribed? Options are cimetidine, famotidine, lansoprazole, rentidine. So the correct answer is cimetidine. That is our option number A. Okay. Now, our next question. At autopsy, a body is found to have copious fine lethargy fraught in mouth and nostrils, which increased on pressure over chest. Which of the following was most likely cause of death? Options are epilepsy, hanging, drowning, opium poisoning. So the correct answer is drowning. Okay. Our next question. Corpus callosotomy is useful in treatment of, options are epilepsy, stroke, Alzheimer disease, none of the above. So the correct answer is epilepsy. Okay, now let's move to our next question. So this is the question. Which of the following drugs is not used in juvenile myoclonic epilepsy? Options are Domiramat, Jonisamide, Carbamazepine, Valproate. So the correct answer is Carbamazepine. That is our option number C is correct. So our next question is this. All of the following factors are associated with substantially greater risk of developing epilepsy after febrile seizures, except complex febrile seizures, early age of onset, developmental abnormalities, positive family history of epilepsy. So the correct answer is early age of onset. That is our option number B is correct. So our option number, next question is this one. An adolescent is brought to the emergency department following an episode of myoclonic jerks at morning after waking up. His consciousness was not impaired. His EEG shows generalized 3-4 hertz spike and slow wave complexes. Most probable diagnosis is generalized tonic-clonic seizures, absent seizure, temporal lobe epilepsy, juvenile myoclonic epilepsy. The correct answer is juvenile myoclonic epilepsy. That is our option number D is correct. So now the next question is this. Which one of the following characteristic feature of juvenile myoclonic epilepsy? Options are myoclonic seizures frequently occur in morning, complete remission is common, response to anticonvulsants is poor, associated absence seizures are presently in majority of patients. So the correct answer is myoclonic seizures frequently occur in morning. That is option number A is correct. So now the next question. Which of the following statements is incorrect in relation to pregnant women with epilepsy? Options are A. The rate of congenital malformation is increased in the offspring of women with epilepsy. Seizure frequently increases in approximately 70% of women. C. Breastfeeding is safe with most anticonvulsants. D. Folic acid supplementation may reduce the risk of neural tube defect. The correct answer is option number B, that is, seizure frequently increases in approximately 70% of women. Okay. So, our next question. This one. Triad of tuberous cirrhosis include all except epilepsy, low intelligence, hydrocephalus, adenoma, sebaceum. So the correct. Okay guys, that's all for now. I hope you like the video. So please like and share this video as much as you can. And if you haven't subscribed our channel, please subscribe it now. I hope you like this video. Thank you guys. Have a nice day. Bye bye.